Kids.
Hi. The Sooty Show is one of the world's longest-running television programs. It's older than Crossroads and even older than Coronation Street.
Poor old Sooty's upset because we're looking for him.
Today, at least 5 million people, not all of them children, watch the program every week. Sooty was discovered by Harry Corbett in 1948. At the time, Harry was working as an engineer and enjoying his hobby conjuring at weekends, performing at children's parties. When he first spotted the teddy bear in a toy shop on Blackpool Pier, he thought the bear could help him with his magic show. At that time, he had no idea of the fame and fortune that would come his way. Television was just beginning in the early 1950s, and everyone who'd seen Sooty with Harry thought he would be a natural for this new form of entertainment.
Hello there.
So, in May 1952, Harry and Sooty appeared on the BBC for the first time. This was in black and white, of course.
Game with these three wooden blocks, and I'm hoping that Sooty will buy it, sell it in his shop. You can come with me if you like. Come on.
Harry's plan of having Sooty assist him with the tricks very quickly came to nothing.
Hello.
From the beginning, the bear started to steal the show.
I say, wait till all your friends go on. Sooty, how's business these days? Oh dear, not very good. Oh well, never mind. What am I going to buy? Oh, Sooty, now, as a matter of fact, I'm not going to buy anything at all. I've come to sell you something.
And then the BBC said we're starting a new series in the autumn called Saturday Special. I said Saturday Special, of which Peter Butterworth was the star. And they said, would you like to do six programmes, 6 minutes each? The total fee was 12 guineas per programme. They went out once a fortnight. And I did want to give up the job. I was very nice job with security and pension and all that sort of thing. But I wrote to the firm and said, can I have 6 Saturdays off to do this job? And they said, no, you can't. You can't mix television and engineering. What are all the other surveyors going to say? It's up to you. So I had to hand in my notice. So we started. However, as soon as we appeared in the autumn on Saturday Special, Chad Valley Toy Company came along and said, can we have the sole rights to make the puppet, which was what I was waiting for. And one of the things that really swayed me into having a go at all this was the fact that at that time, Muffin the Mule had a syndicate turning over £30,000 a year on merchandising and royalties. That was Muffin the Mule in 1952. And I thought, my goodness, if we could get anywhere halfway there, you know, it's worth having a bash.
All right, off we go.
You see, there was no competition in those days. It was the perfect spot at the weekend. Saturday tea time, and the whole family watched it.
It's just like a flying saucer at the end of that stick, isn't it?
And there was no ITV, so if anybody who had a television set saw Sooty.
What?
There was an old geezer on there, wasn't there? I don't know his first name.
Harry Corbett, I remember Harry Corbett, the old one.
Yeah. When I used to watch it, it was it Ronnie Corbett was presenting it?
Did you used to watch Sooty?
Yeah, all the time, I still do.
You still watch it?
Yeah.
Why?
Well, it's great. And sweet.
What do you like about it?
It's cuddly.
Almost everyone has some memory of the bear.
Well, sitting with the children glued to the television, which, of course, was really comparatively new even in those days, and Sooty had an unbelievable fascination for them. I think they almost put themselves in his guise, you know, so that they could be naughty, but they didn't dare. He's always doing naughty things, wasn't he? And the children loved it. They laughed. I was at a show where a lecture or something like that, where Sooty also appeared, and he came up behind me and squirted me full in the face with a water squirter, and I was ruined for the whole evening because instead of going out on the platform looking well coiffured and made up, I was soaked. So you can see what he does even to grown-ups. I think it's fun.
Nobody, it seems, could escape the deadly aim of Sooty's water pistol, whoever they were. In an attempt to bring the bear down to earth, Harry introduced a new character to the show, Sweep.
No, don't do anything else to him, please. Sooty.
Unfortunately, the plan backfired once again. Sweep seemed to bring out the worst in him.
You may as well finish it up. Go on. Hey, go stay with that stuff. You know, you shouldn't have done this. You know what, Sweep is. You're going to be in awful trouble. Sweep, I wouldn't. No, don't, please. No. Oh. Look, Sooty, don't do anything else. Oh, dearie me. Look, I better say bye-bye now whilst we're still able. I can see it. It's not going to be possible later on. Boys, must you do this? No, listen. Stop it, Sooty. No, please.
As Sweep's presence on the show didn't seem to be helping matters at all, Harry had another brainwave. He'd give Sooty a girlfriend. Perhaps that would do the trick.
A reporter from the Daily Mail came to see me. We were doing the show in Wimbledon. He said, any new puppets coming along, Harry? And I said, no, I'm afraid not. I said, I was going to introduce one a year ago, a girlfriend, but the BBC wouldn't let me. He said, why not? I said, because they said it was sex creeping in. He said, can I print that in the Daily Mail? I said, well, it's true. You ring them up and ask them. So he did, and he printed it. And Fleet Street went mad. So the BBC rang me up and said, what is going on? Have you got a vendetta against the BBC? We have a contract going through at the present time, and it will not be signed if you say one more word. I said, but I haven't said anything except the truth, you know. Anyway, after all that, we had to have a girlfriend because we've got thousands of pounds worth of publicity.
Did you want a voice something like this, Sue?
Harry's wife, Marjorie, really provided the voice for Sue. More.
But, you know, she's enjoyed working with us ever so much. Yes. And she loves boys and girls. And she loves Auntie Marjorie and Uncle Harry.
And it's a bit of a job to stop her talking as well.
Well, it is sometimes. She I does. Do enjoy talking, Mr. Cook. And I'm talking, very fond of Sooty and Sweet.
Oh, hello, you three. Well, nice to see you. Happy birthday, Sooty. Say, what's this?
Oh, it's Sooty's birthday present. It's a magic box.
Magic box? Oh, let's try it. Let's see if we can magic. So you've got your magic wand down there, Sooty. Get it up for him, Sweep. That's it, magic wand. But just have a look in the box and see if it's empty first, shall we? Just a minute. Is it empty? Sure. Right, well, we'll put this back in there then. That's it. Give it a tap with your magic wand. Shall we have a look? Shall we? Here we go then. Just a minute. Oh! Look here!
In 1968, after 15 years with the BBC, a bombshell. Sooty got the sack. Thames Television came to the rescue.
Could you bring the tarpaulin?
Yeah.
The astroturf and the cushions.
They gave Sooty the star treatment. While the BBC believed that British puppets were old-fashioned and dull, Thames gave Sooty the budgets and staff to make bigger and better programmes. The show was taken out of the studio, and the little teddy bear who'd started life in a Blackpool toy shop came into his own as a television star of the 70s. Sooty and his friends took to the new glamorous, fast life immediately. But as the pace increased, so did the pressure for Harry. On Christmas Day, 1975, Harry had a heart attack. Sooty took to his bed in despair. Who would look after him now? Luckily, he'd always got on well with the Corbett family, especially Matthew. On hearing the bad news about his father's illness, Matthew agreed to take over the program and give up his own career in show business. To start with, this was just going to be a short-term arrangement until Harry was better.
Could I have Sooty and Sweetman, please?
However, it took Harry a long time to get better. And today, 7 years later, Matthew and Sooty have made over 100 programs together. Each program needs at least 30 highly specialized technicians, sometimes more, to bring the stories to life.
Hello.
Yes.
I look like Duncan Goodhue.
Okay, well, you've got Duncan that Goodhue, mark, okay?
No, I'm not yet.
The director of this particular episode, Stan Woodward, has a hard time keeping Sooty and his friends in check.
87, take one. Action.
Up they come.
Oh, hello. I look like Duncan Goodhue. Oh, maybe that's because I am Duncan Goodhue. Yeah, honestly, you're sweet, aren't you? Yeah, nice to meet you. Oh, Sooty, nice to meet you, Sooty.
Go.
And we cut. We've cut.
Yes. Yes, better. Yes, thank you. Okay. Good work for me. Good we will be taking this position.
Many of these technicians have worked with some of the most important names in show business. They've been on location filming all over the world, but they all have a soft spot for the bear.
97, take one.
What's that listening of yours there, JK?
And action.
Oh, wait. Sooty, Duncan, do you mind? Very funny. Look at this.
Oh, I am soaking wet. Look at the state of me. Look, you go and stand over there, and I'll turn the stopcock on. All right?
That sounds like a great idea.
You go and stand over there.
Expert with water, eh? We'll see. I'll turn the stopcock on.
Are you there? You ready?
Yes. Just watch this.
One, two, three, go!
Keep it running. A bit more, Peter.
I'll go over there. I'm not staying over here. I'll go over this side. I'll go over here.
That's what I'll do. Okay.
La, 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 la.
The music for each Sooty program is composed by Matthew, working in his own recording studio, which he's built in his back garden.
Once upon a time lived a dirty young man. Never washed his face and he never washed his hands. That's why they call him Dirty Jack. Now this little boy didn't seem to care. He didn't clean his shoes and he never brushed.
He finds working on his own, often late into the night, the best way to write. But Sooty is not always prepared to let Matthew get on with it on his own.
Jack didn't fit in with the rest. In fact, they thought he was a dirty little pest. That's why they...
Just a minute. What are you doing here? Look, I'm trying to do a song for the series. Well, it's in your interest. What do you want to do? Do you want to play the drums? It's not really the sort of song. All right, do you want to play this? All right, here we go. We're in record. Okay, demonstration with Sooty playing the drums. Ready? After four. One, two, three, go.
So it's not really surprising that Sooty's rehearsal studio is in the middle of a forest. So after the location filming is finished, the director and his assistant travel every day to meet with Matthew and his team.
thoughts on the rehearsal changes, Matthew?
I don't know. I don't know what's happened. It's just that, you know, something goes very well.
How long have you been doing judo, by the way, Stan? Pretty nice, isn't it? Go on.
Morning, everybody.
Good morning, Matthew. Sooty and Sweep have got the most terrible colds.
Oh, no.
At this rehearsal, Sue's part is read by one of the assistants.
Oh, you Sweep. How do you feel, Sue?
Oh, I'm fine, thank you, Matthew.
Yeah?
Mind you, I didn't go to the swing bars with you and the boys yesterday.
No, well, it did feel rather too cold to go swimming. Look, I think the best thing that you can do is to... Sit up a minute, Sooty. I think the best thing you can do... Sweet, would you sit up, please? That's it. The best thing you... Sooty, would you sit up? The best thing you can all... Would you sit up, Sweet, please? The best... Look, both of you. The best thing you can do is to do something and keep active. Sooty, a nice warm shower. That'll make you feel better. Yeah? A nice warm bath will make you feel better. Yes, I'm sure it will. What about you, Sue?
Well, as I said before, I've been washed. And now I think I'll do some tidying up before breakfast is ready.
All right then, Sue.
There's a lot of Grandpa Sooty's old things in the cupboard under the stairs.
I told you.
Each program is rehearsed for 4 or 5 days, planning the moves, changing the script, and working out any problems.
It's early bed for you tonight.
Each season of shows consists of 20 different programs, and each program is made up of hundreds of different shots. Stan, the director, always draws each scene onto his script, rather like a comic, so that everyone can understand who should be where and where the camera should be.
Okay. Right. Down. Down.
When all the outside filming for each episode is completed, the next stage takes place at the television studio.
See, why have I woken you up? You could have your makeup on, Midge. Can you just do something with him? Just...
I think he's fine as he is, Matthew.
Do you think he's all right? Why don't I get made up? I've already been made up. You can't see it, probably. Just a minute, I'll put these on for you. Can't see it, Midge. Look, 10 years younger. I'm glad you said that. You've done a fine job, Mitch. Thanks. Look, we've got to go in the studio and get the program made. Come on, down there. What is it? I look a bit hot. What do you mean I look a bit hot? What are you doing? No, don't do that. You just made me up. For goodness sake. It's for the documentary. Never. You're not meant to see that documentary, can we? Get in there. Sorry, Mitch.
We're so temperamental.
Well, it's nothing to do with me.
I know.
Look. It's just camera struck. Will you get down there, please? You won't do it again. Look at the time as well. No, not you. You don't have to look at the time. Will you get down there, please? Judy?
The difference between the studio and the location filming is that in the studio are the insides of Sooty's and Matthew's house. And instead of there being only one camera,
Nick?
There are three or four. All the sets are specially built for the show, and they're 6 times smaller than real life and often cost 2 or 3 times as much.
How do you do that? It's very clever, isn't it?
I don't know. Sooty gets in.
Yeah. Okay, right. If you'd just like to sit there, Sooty, for a while. I'm sorry. How long are we going to be then? Because it's a bit painful. There's a slap on the wrist by a boom mic. Now, do you really want to do this documentary or not? I mean, you know, if you don't, just say so. It's quite easy. So, Peter, I'm looking after Sweep. Yes. Judy's looking after Sooty in the bar. And you're doing two.
15.
Right, Nick, are you happy with the water?
I'm already with water.
And Judy, Mr. Peter...
Because Sooty and his friends are very fond of water, Matthew and his team take extra special care. They always wear their swimming costumes for the bathroom scenes.
Seconds.
Sweet magicked himself into thin air. I wonder where he's going to appear next.
Freeze. Sweep in. Here we go, watch me. 3, 2.
Get out!
So this is...
Each scene in the studio is rehearsed separately, and it can take as much as 5 hours to record a single 20-minute programme.
See the camera?
That was the trouble. That was the problem.
That was the problem.
Can
you see the monitor?
Yeah, three times if you can. Right.
Good. That's it, then. Right,
Marilyn,
we're going to set up...
Is there any chance you could move that monitor over to the side? Marilyn, can I just see the script for the words stuff, please?
You never guess what, so it turned out to be these things causing all the trouble.
There's been one big change in the lives of Sooty and his friends in the last few years. Matthew's mother, who'd always given Sue her voice, has retired. Yes, so a new voice had to be found for Sue.
You did turn out to be a sport, didn't he?
You have had a day of it, haven't you?
Today, her part is read by actress Brenda Longman.
Freshen you up. Oh, great.
When everyone's happy with each scene, it's recorded on videotape.
Oh, no. Not a glass of water. I've seen enough of this stuff to last me a lifetime, Sue.
I'm sorry, Matthew. Don't let it get you down.
Okay, Nick, that scene went...
The director works in a control room above the studio where he can see shots from all the different cameras.
Set up in the meantime for Sooty's bedroom and we'll roll tennis inning. Coming off the clock. Thank you. A clock going up.
Roll tennis.
Gradually, shot by shot, scene by scene, the programme comes together.
Zero.
Look. All right, Duncan, you can turn it on now. Go on.
Okay, don't be in such a hurry. Yes.
Go on, turn it off.
Matthew, it's okay, I found it.
Pardon?
I found the problem.
It's only good.
Thank you very much, everybody. That's a wrap. Thank you. Good day, Shoot. Thank you very much.
Please take all your rubbish with you.
Thank you.
And yes, let's...
all of the rods. We have to complete that next time.
Sooty is a hard-working bear, but television is only one side of his work. For 6 months of the year, he tours the country with his live show. But however busy he becomes, he always finds a few days each year to spend with his old dad and sometimes Sooty. Learn a new trick or two.
Oh, there you are. I say, Sooty, just come over here a minute. I want you to show all your friends your tap dancing shoes. Just pop them on, will you, and come up here. I spent an awful lot of time making them. Oh, that was quick. You got them on? Oh, yes. Right. Well, just pop your leg up and we can see them. Pop your leg up. How about those? They're smashing. Can you see that little toe cap as well, the metal toe cap? Just hop around so they can see in the camera. There we are. Can you see them? Lovely, aren't they? All right, Sooty, take your leg down now. There we are. I say, what about doing a little tap dance, just to show them how it works? Okay. Well, I've got your little radio here. So I'll just switch on for you to find a bit of music. Hey, that's it. Now, get ready, now. Just say bye-bye. Bye-bye, everyone. Bye-bye.